Hello, everybody out there in social media land. It's your personal injury family law attorney, Derek Burns, and here to answer more legal questions. And this one is coming from the family quasi-criminal. And it says, the question I get is, what qualifies for an injunction? What qualifies for an injunction? And that is a very broad thing to do. So depending on where you're watching this, obviously I'm in Florida, so I'm going to give you some Floridian advice. There's different categories of injunctions against different people. Your most standard ones that you're going to see when people are looking for injunctions is in a domestic setting. So you're married to the person, you're in a sexual relationship, you live with them, things of that nature, your brother and sister, those types of things are going to be the most common. You might also find stalking, cyber stalking type of injunctions. But basically, when it comes down to it, what qualifies for it when it comes to stalking and things of that nature is when the person has really no reason to be doing what they're doing, right? No reason at all. If somebody's contacting you regarding a bill that's due, well, that has a reason, right? Maybe they're annoying, nuisance, but not an injunction, right? Unless it's gone crazy. But when it comes to domestic violence and things of that nature, if somebody's putting their hands on you, if they're a threat to you, that will qualify. So it's a really loaded question that I can't get into easily. But if you have a specific question about, hey, this is what's going on, XYZ123, reach out to a good attorney. In the family law criminal section, a lot of people go hand in hand on who you want in that injunction because it is sensitive stuff. So reach out to somebody in that area, ask them the question specifically to your case, and they can answer what they believe will happen if you get go for the injunction. But keep those questions coming, guys. I appreciate it. Leave a comment in the box.